Father, in Jesus' name, we give you praise, we give you honor. Thank you because of this opportunity that you have given me to share the word of God. Pray for my listeners, wherever they are. Pray, King of Glory, that as I share the word of God, let it be anointed by you and bless my listeners in Jesus' name. I pray. Amen. Dear listener, this is your friend, Reverend Dr. Tom Gayo, and I want to share with you the word of God from the book of 1 Samuel chapter 30, verse number 1 to verse number 20, and I am talking about how to reclaim that which has been stolen from you. And I'll read a few verses. I'll read verse 1 to 6 and also verse number 18 and then carry on because of time. Bible says, and it came to pass when David and his men were come to Ziklag on the third day that the Amalekites had invaded the south of Ziklag and smitten Ziklag and burned it with fire. Had taken women captives that were therein, they slew not any, either great or small, but carried them away and went their way. Verse 3 says, so David and his men came to the city, and behold, it was burned with fire, and their wives and their sons and their daughters were taken captive. Verse 4 says, then David and the people that were with him lifted up their voices and wept until there was no more power to weep. Verse number 6 then says, David's two wives were taken captive, Ahinoam the Jezreelitess and Abigail the wife of Nabal the Carmelite. Verse 6, and David was greatly distressed, for the people spoke of stoning him because of the soul of the people who had grieved, every man for his soul and for his daughter. But David encouraged himself in the Lord his God. Ladies and gentlemen, I don't know how you respond to loss. How do you respond to loss? And how do you go about reclaiming that which has been taken away from you? I believe that the answer to this question lies in this story of David and his 600 men. I want to state that this is the story of David at Ziklag. David and his men were at this particular time were living in Ziklag. And this is because David had run away from Saul, who actually sought to destroy him. And when he was in Ziklag, there was a day that the king Achish requested that David goes to fight together with him, fight against Saul together with him. But when they were away, together with his 600 men, the Amalekites struck their town when they were away, and they took away their wives and their sons and their daughters, and they burned everything with fire. And I want us to look at how David went about reclaiming that which had been stolen, or rather taken away from him. In verse number 6 of 1 Samuel 30, the Bible says, now David was greatly distressed, for the people spoke of stoning him because of the souls of the people who had grieved every man for his sons and his daughters. But David strengthened himself in the Lord. So one of the ways, as I stated previously, one way of claiming that which has been taken away from you is actually by you beginning by encouraging yourself. And this is what we see David doing. You know, you actually cannot be able to pursue your enemy and overcome your enemy if you don't actually encourage yourself. And that's why we look at David here. You know, David was a great warrior. And actually, there's a lot that we can be able to learn from the life of David. And one of the things that we can learn from the life of David, that which actually made him to be a mighty warrior. Remember, this is the David that killed Goliath. This is a David that actually once killed a lion. This is a David that actually killed a bear. This is a David who actually, a king with his army sought after him to destroy him, but that king, King Saul, was not able to destroy him. What is this that actually made David every other time to bounce back? It's like, you know, it is normally said in English that a cat has seven lives. So you look at David, actually, it's like this man had seven lives, because despite what he had to go through, David was able to bounce back to life. And one of the things that I'm learning that David did is that David learned the secret of encouraging himself in the Lord. And how did he go about doing this? I want to tell us that David went about doing this by the means of actually, you know, getting time alone with God and his word, and letting the word of God to speak to him. This is how he did it. He encouraged himself by, you know, getting some time alone with God and the word of God, and letting the word of God to encourage him. So I want to tell us that time comes. You know, I know it's good to be encouraged by other people, but I want to tell you, you might not actually, you know, be very, very lucky to have people around you all the time. There are times you will not have people around you. There are times when you are alone. Actually, there are even moments in your life or stages in your life when people run away from you. When things become very tough, they might run away from you. So actually, you know, you need to learn the secret of actually, you know, encouraging yourself in the Lord. And you do this by the means of getting yourself alone with God and the word of God. And when you do this, brethren, you can actually be able to draw strength from the word of God. And this was the secret of David. Psalms 143, verse 4 to 12, the Bible says, this is about David. And actually, this is what this was his habit. The Bible says, look at how he handled situations. This is Psalms 143, verse number 4 to 12. It says, therefore, my spirit is overwhelmed within me. My heart within me is distressed. Verse 5, I remember the days of old. I meditate on all your works, and I muse on the works of your hands. I spread out my hands to you, and my soul longs for you, for you like a thirsty land. Answer me speedily, O Lord. My spirit fails. Do not hide your face from me, lest I be like those who go down into the pit. Cause me to hear your loving guidance in the morning, for in you do I trust. Cause me to know the way in which I should walk. For I lift up my soul to you. Deliver me, O Lord, from my enemies. In you I take shelter. Teach me to do your will, for you are my God. Your spirit is good. Lead me in the land of righteousness, and revive me, Lord, for your name's sake. For your righteousness' sake, bring my soul out of trouble. In your mercy, cut my enemies and destroy all those who have afflicted my soul, for I am your son. Look at this, brethren. David learned the secret of getting alone with God and actually, you know, communing with God, speaking to God. And thereby, David actually was able to encourage himself. So if we are ever going to recover that which we have lost, we must learn the secret of encouraging ourselves in the Lord. Number two, choose to seek God. You read the Bible in 1 Samuel chapter 7, verse number 7. The Bible says, then David said to Abiathar the priest, Ahimelech's son, please bring me the ephod here to me. Abiathar brought the ephod to David. You read verse number 7. The Bible, verse number 8 says, and David inquired at the Lord, saying, shall I pursue after the troop? Shall I overtake them? And he answered him, pursue, for thou shalt surely overtake them, and they without fail recover all. So, number two, if you are ever going to reclaim that which has been lost from you, you should seek guidance and direction from God. Ladies and gentlemen, many times we have actually, you know, depended on our own knowledge and understanding. And I want to tell us today that when you are a person who only depends on your own knowledge and understanding, I want to tell you that you are prone to fail. But when you depend on God, you allow God to guide you and to lead you, you will not fail. You read Proverbs, actually, chapter 3 and verse number 5, 6 and 7. The Bible says, trust in the Lord with all thine heart, and lean not on your own understanding. In all thy ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy paths. Then 7 says, be not wise in your own eyes, for that eyes fear the Lord and depart from evil. So, If we are ever going to reclaim that which you have lost, the second thing you need to do, and which is very important, which David did, please learn to seek guidance and direction from God. Don't actually, you know, lean on your own understanding. Yeah? You should actually be able to acknowledge God in all your ways. In other words, before you take a step, you should actually be able to pray. And I want to tell you today, this is what David did, and he was very victorious in all his battles. Why? Because David would not actually go to battle unprepared. He would always prepare spiritually. You know, most of us, sometimes we actually, you know, pursue our destinies. And, you know, our destinies while we are spiritually bankrupt. Don't do that. You need actually to pursue your destiny and your enemies when you are actually, you know, you are spiritually upright. And this is what David did. I want to tell you today, please don't lean on your own understanding and your wisdom. Choose to depend on God. That's why David actually, before he pursued the Amalekites to recover that which he had lost, he actually prayed. He asked the priest Abiathar to pray together with him. And God spoke to him very vividly that now you can pursue, and when you pursue, you will overtake. I want to conclude by stating this, that we actually, brethren, sometimes are unwise when we do embark on new pathways without actually prayer. Don't pursue new pathways without prayer. Don't make major decisions without prayer, without seeking the face of God. When you do that, you are bound to fail. But when you pray, seek the face of God, then you will not fail. So I've said two things. One, if you are going to actually reclaim that which you have lost, like David, please do encourage yourself in the Lord. And then number two, I've said, seek God. Seek the wisdom of God, the guidance and the direction of God. And when you do that, dear listener, you'll be able to reclaim that which you have lost. Let's pray. Father, we thank you for the word of God that I've spoken. I pray for my listeners that as they pursue that which the enemy has taken away from them, you are going to help them to encourage themselves in you, and at the same time to seek your face and your direction, so that, King of Glory, they will actually bring back that which the enemy had taken away from them. Touch your people and bless them and heal the sick. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
For you are great, and my heart